the concept of the brains or the neuron. So these are nothing but, these are the input layer, and these are nothing but neurons, which is seen in our brains, or how our brains really work. So these are the neurons, these are interconnected to each other. So these neurons send information to these neurons, and these are the final output, means the final insights. So input nodes, suppose this is the eye, this is the brain, and this is the final results. Like suppose we are seeing a picture of cat, so our eye will see the picture of cat, and this brain part will calculate, will like tell us this is the picture of cat, and we will get the thought that, or we'll say that this is the picture of cat. So these are the input nodes where we will be inserting the inputs, and these are the hidden nodes where we'll be processing our inputs, and these are the final output nodes. So how deep learning is much more superior to the machine learning process is that, as you can see from the graph, as the data set, amount of data is increasing, most of the learning algorithm fails. Really, like we can say, the learning algorithm has really gone down, and the deep learning is performing much, performance of the deep learning process has gone up here. So deep learning process is much more superior compared to the other learning algorithm. Now, deep learning approach. So, like as I have said, we see the, saw the picture of the cat, dog, and there are two pictures of cats, two different types of cat, and the picture of dog. So, this is the learning algorithm, or we can say of neural networks. So, these neural networks will understand or will be trained depending upon the these pictures. Like our learning algorithm now have the idea like how the cat looks like, or how the dog looks like. So once it is a trained, now we have a model prepared here. We have a trained model, and we'll tell our model to predict. We'll give the new picture to our model and try to tell him like, can you tell me what this picture really about? So once our model will see the picture, it will tell us that it is a picture of dog. So this is the way the deep learning process really works. Now, deep learning areas of application. So there are infinite number of areas in which deep learning can be really applied. So some of them are computer vision, image processing, speech recognition, and time series analysis. So in this session, like I will discussing about how to analyze the time series data using the deep learning process. So like I have taken the data of the stock market and try to analyze like what will the future trends of the stock market based on the by using the deep learning tools and methods. So this is the last slide, and we can like go into like how to do the data analysis process. So since there is no supporting cable for this one, so like I want you people to see here like how to do the data analysis using the Python. So so as I discussed about this this one completion called as a zero. So like I discussed about the zero completion, like when we are predicting the housing prices. So we have data set, and like I have data set collected. I can show you the data set also. And like it is a big data actually.
Real time. So when
data set of that Zillow thing I have discussed, properties data set, like how to evaluate the price of any properties or house. So
this also you have heard in Nepal, right?
Yeah, this thing also happened. I'll show you like how it is done. It's just so much time. So like, I'll show you here. So like this is the pandas. Panda is nothing but tools that I'll be using to study the file or read the file. And this is NumPy and Matplotlib. Like this, it has a functionality of MATLAB software. So MATLAB software can be simulated in Python using the NumPy and Matplotlib. And Seaborn is used for the visualization purpose. And this is the training data set. Like, train 2016.csv. So this is the training data set I'll be using, and I'll be combining this this part, okay, this data set with that. So it has a parcel ID. Parcel ID is nothing but the plot ID. We call it, in America they call it parcel ID, I think. And then air conditioning type, architectural ID, basement square foot, bathroom square foot, like they have considered lots of parameters in order to evaluate the properties. So we can, as you can see that there are like almost, how many? So there are more than 100, I think. More than 100 columns are there. Like they are, yeah, more than 100 features are there. So they will be using all the features in order to evaluate their properties of the price of the properties. So in our program, like I have studied, first I have loaded this 2016.csv file. So in 2016.csv, so this is the parcel ID. For this parcel ID, what is the log error? Means predicted price minus the actual price. So what is the error? Residual error means what the residual error that is obtained. So what we have to do is we have to minimize this residual error part. And this is the transaction date. Means on this date the transaction has happened. So and now, so if I want to see like what my data really has or what my file really contain, so I'll be using train_df.head, and it gives me parcel ID, log error, transaction date and transaction month. So this is the transaction month. Like I've extracted from the transaction date, I've extracted transaction month and I've listed here. So in which month the transaction has really happened. So transaction data type. So like this is the pre-processing part. Means before analyzing the data, I want to know like what my data really, what is the type of the data. So we can see that the first parcel ID is the integer type, then second log is a float type, and transaction date is the date type data set, and transaction month is again int 64. Now since I want to know I want to predict this part, log error part, so I have to understand what my log error data type really is, or what is the what is the shape of my data. Suppose like I want to know the anomaly in the data set, or if my data is normally distributed or not. So I have to visualize the data part. So the visualization part come here. So you can see that it is the stepwise data set, like stepwise data, and these are the anomalies. So all the data are here normals, and these data points that are deviated from the original parts are the abnormal data set. So like in the common data science practice, we will be deleting this part or omitting this part. But in this Zillow competition, since we have to minimize the value, we'll be considering this part also, since everything is essential. Now count, like I want to count like how many transactions have really happened, like in which month how many transactions have really happened. Suppose like in month of January, how many transactions has happened? In month of February, how many transactions have happened? So I'll be aggregating the transaction based on the month, like in which month how many transactions have happened. So this is the plot that is obtained. 6, 8, 5, 7, 4, like in this month these are the transactions, this minute, like these are the number of transactions that are really happened. So now here I have visualized this thing. This is the log error, means the data set or the point that I am trying to predict. So like I was trying to see if my data is normally distributed or not, or my data is point that I am trying to predict is a normal data point or not. So as you can see here, this is the median part and the data points are normally distributed the longest side. So it is a curved shape data or bell shape data set. So we can say that it is a normally distributed data set. And again, here, yeah. So month of transaction and number of transaction occurred in that month, like what I was discussing that time. So in which month, how many transactions has really happened? So in month first, it is more than 6,000. So highest number of transactions has been happened in month 6. So we can see from this data, means in which month the more number of transactions or frequency of transaction is more. Now, since we are predicting on the number of data points or the features, so I'll be considering lots of the features. So our features is in properties 2016.csv file. So I'll be reading that file also. As you can see, there are lots many features here. So now I have read that property 2016 file in our data set, in our program. So now here I have missed, so I want to see like how many columns are there missing values in there, like my data set contains some of the missing values or not. So like if there are missing values, the missing values produce some of the bad results or help in the bad, yeah. So I want to see how many missing values are there. So in which columns or in which features, how many missing values are there. So I have plotted this here. So highest number of missing values are in this story type ID. It is almost more than 30 lakhs of the missing values are there in that feature. So least number of missing values in the FIPS property, land, use ID and row census type ID. Like in this, they have the least number of missing values. And as you can see, the number of missing values increasing as we go downward.